So when we all first start reselling, we're just so excited to make money. We want to go out, we want to hit the garage sales, the thrift stores. We want to start finding these items that we're studying on the sold listings, on YouTube, Facebook, and we want to go out there, find it, and make money. But one of the biggest mistakes that people make is once they start making money, what happens is you're going to have to pay taxes. And essentially, every single sale you make, you're going to have to pay taxes on 100% in full, minus any tax write-offs. But in order to write things off, you're going to have to track your receipts, and you're going to have to know what your write-offs are, and you're going to have to be keeping track of them. And one of the biggest mistakes that people make is they don't track what they purchase. So a lot of times people will purchase with cash. They'll buy items from the thrift store, cash, garage sales, cash, and they're not saving their receipts, or they're not writing themselves a receipt. And what I mean is, if you go to a garage sale and you pay cash, obviously you're not going to be able to get a receipt from them. But one thing you can do is you can go over to Walmart or Target, wherever, and get a little receipt book. You know, it's got the white page and the yellow page. You write yourself a receipt and then you keep a copy. You literally are giving yourself a receipt, and you could write down what the address is, so on and so forth. But it's important to track your purchases, and it's important to, you know, write yourself receipts accurately as time goes on at flea markets, garage sales, so on and so forth. So you're able to track your cost of goods sold. So, you know, that's going to be one of your biggest expenses is, you know, items that you're sourcing. Also, you know, you're going to keep track of all your fees and PayPal and eBay and Amazon expenses and subscriptions, so on and so forth. But a lot of people, they don't track this. They don't get this down. So, you know, one of the things you can do is get yourself a little folder organizer. And what I used to do is I used to just write down each month, and I would print out all the receipts, and I would track it that way, and I would put all the receipts in there. And then at the end of each month, I would input it into GoDaddy bookkeeping. I use QuickBooks now, and I have a team that helps me, but you've got to have a system to track your expenses. And one of the expenses that a lot of people don't fully take advantage of are their sourcing expenses. So save your receipts, try to use credit cards as much as you can responsibly, because that'll help you track things and organize your input when it comes to your cost of goods sold. And remember, you can't write off what you purchase until it sells. So get yourself a good accountant, and they'll talk to you about cost of goods sold, which means you spent money on an item, and once it sells, you can write off that expense. So just want to make a quick video about that. If you have any questions, drop a comment below. Much love.